Success is not a harbor, but a voyage that ripples and twists, shifting imperceptibly back over courses already charted. These sailboats on the Chesapeake wait for Sunday sailors. But there was a time when ships like these chased and caught the wind for profit, carrying cargo to the world. The spill of wind for power. Success then, and perhaps again. Although it seems impossible, some sailing craft can actually go faster than the speed of wind. An ice boat with minimal friction can go 4 times as fast. In recent years, some people have questioned our traditional ways of catching the wind at sea. One designer wants to build ships, not with sails, but with windmills to power the ship's propellers. The Japanese have launched an oil tanker that runs with wind. And here in Norfolk Harbor, you're going to see a tugboat unlike any you've ever seen before. It's called a Tugantine.
We're getting some wind out there now. Flag off, Jesse.
Part tugboat, part sailboat.
Oh, you say that, yep.
It started as a joke, a way for Lane Briggs to enter a sailing regatta. But when he noticed the 28% savings in fuel, the sails stayed on.
There's lots of people who referred to us as nuts in the vein. But the only thing I can say, she's making her bank payments.
For the first time in this century, a cold-hearted look at the business of the sea shows that sail power can turn a better profit than diesel alone. Joe Spivey built this 2-masted cargo schooner when the price of diesel fuel rose tenfold in the past decade. He runs an inboard motor when he must, but the silent press of wind on sails keeps his bottom line afloat.
We felt like we had to go with something that was proven, something that we knew would work, something that had been used commercially and had been used successfully commercially.
Some freighters now pay $11,000 a day for fuel, more than half their total operating expenses. Sea trade is down worldwide because of that high cost. But Joe and his wife Sharon make a good living with a ship whose basic design is 100 years old.
The development took hundreds of years, and it seemed silly to throw all that knowledge away.
The Spiveys had watched small supply boats shuttling canned goods for huge profits in the Bahamas.
I got it. Go ahead.
Figured they could do the same in this country if they could keep costs down. Old sailing captains showed them how. Sharon stitched the sails. Joe sold the family farm to finance their dream.
There it comes.
But they were soon faced with an unforeseen problem.
Coming to you.
The Coast Guard has no category for motorized sailing ships, and the ancient design that put them in business is barnacled with legislation, unchanged since the age of sail.
We in neutral?
Yeah, in neutral.
Okay, I'm gonna start her up.
If the Spiveys dropped their engine, they could be fully licensed, but their motor keeps them safe and their cargo on schedule. The Spiveys testified before Congress last year, but so far, nothing has changed.
If something doesn't happen for us, personally, we're gonna have to start flying a foreign flag so we can be legal.
Will the Spiveys abandon their American dream?
I'm a businessman, I'm not a dreamer. The real world is out with the wind in your teeth and the rain driving down and having to get up, even though you don't feel like it, and take in sail and take care of the boat. It's not being able to call in sick.
The real world is also an unknown fog, and folks with the courage to face it. For today, Bob Dotson, NBC News, on the Chesapeake Bay.